right, I missed game one, but that was a quick one. So this is the second round. And we're watching the second game. It's a best of five match. Let's see. This should be a competitive match. I wonder why that first game took so short. Ooh, Queen C9. That's very suspicious. Knight takes d11, there's king a7 at the end, then the king runs. This is probably a good decision, but blue will be happy to sacrifice an exchange. Now you probably have to move the king. Maybe king a7. Knight c6 is awfully dangerous. Because then knight... possibly you can defend that. King a7. Yeah, taking this with a knight is risky. Oh, no, 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 no. Queen l7. Yeah, this is a blunder. What? No. Wait, what? Are you serious? K5 would have stopped that. I don't think this is a good move. Queen J7. I think green must go for mate on yellow alone. This is just dead. You probably have to move the pawn here. That's so ugly. Rook takes d11 had no place. You can even take this. It's not working. Red can play bishop b10. There we go, finally some activity. Now you should move the bishop to check blue. This one is playable. Oh, there we go. Muy bonita. All right, that's a queen blunder. Don't do it. No! No! Queen! Queen! La 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 la. Okay. So, the very next movie blunders mate in one. Alright, that was not a good game. Okay. This one will be quick if you continue playing like that. This is on pace for the shortest match so far. Alright, here we go. We'll see if they wake up for the third one. Another 3-0. This time, don't play queen c9. Oh, they are reversed colors, of course. Knight c9. I prefer knight c9 here. I mean, this is not bad. Definitely. Queen m8, almost always needed. Now, yeah, knight i3. Red really needs to finish development before attacking. Oh no! Ah, oh, this is such a bad move. You don't want to play c4. This is a weird move. I guess he wants some. Blue is fixated on developing the queen. I don't like knight k12. You should have followed in the. Follow clash there. Just play e12, capture. Oh, no, me like. Why would you play that? That's such a weird move. It only weakens. That's a free knight. Knight takes m5? What? Ah, this is not good. I don't understand where this attack is going. Doesn't look like it's going anywhere. Like, here I think if you just make a double threat on. Oh, that's not good enough. Yeah. Yeah, you should go all in now. But do you have mate? I don't think so. Oh no. M takes. Yeah, not a bad call. Uh, Unfortunately, red has checks. Yeah, and knight c9. That didn't work. Getting too way too optimistic. Yeah, time to save the bishop. I like this play. Yeah, rook takes is possible. That's a problem. Yeah. At least play bishop h2. I mean, the king is not extremely exposed. Yeah, just safety. Probably knight e10 is a good move. Rook j1. Bishop g12, bishop g4. Well, this is some activity. Are there any tricks? Queen h9. pieces. That was way too passive. I think it's clear that red doesn't know what to do. At least make a pseudo threat. It's not even a threat. Fake. No attack. Green is completely safe. Are they gonna go? Queen M10. Ah. Is there something here? I don't think so. Let them have it. Now it's almost getting interesting. Have to take some stuff now. There's no attack here. Red can't mate alone. So this is just nothing. Yeah, I like this check. That's mate. Not 3-0 after all. found a way. Just any other move. I think you can move the king here. You can take with the other pawn. Alright. Will we get a comeback? Very, very standard. Now some queen activity. Very interesting. More of the same. Yeah, K11 is not gain some space. Good. Oh no. You should give up your queen now, probably. Okay. You can't even stop it. Yeah. That's a free piece. They stopped it. Good play by Clash. Oh, with a pawn. No, this is... I don't like knight takes. Bishop takes was probably better. Knight K4 coming. Now if they don't come back from this one, I don't see them. Well, they have to come back from this one. Just go knight K4. What? I don't like that. You should play knight K4 immediately because you're posting the knight on a nice outpost. Because the pawn moved from the J file. Clash is feeling the heat. The green setup is quite harmonious. boring me with just offer a queen trade here. Pawn push, you have to close it for sure. Yeah, close it, yes. Now you just have to be careful with the king. Yeah, I think green should play knight back, then queen out, and take it from there. You can just block this, move the pawn. Yeah, move the pawn, get the bishop out. Good. Move the knight back. Knight and 10. Blue should just develop the pieces. Knight take, you take this one. The knight here. Then you take that one. No! Okay, I guess that works. You take the rook, take the bishop, or move the bishop in. That's some counterplay. Yeah. Knight takes g4. Definitely. I like offering the queen trade here. I think yellow rook must come and protect the red queen. What? Queen h9. What? Wow. Can't believe he flagged there. Now the check was so weird. You just take the knight there. Just take the knight. So we have a game 5. Two. I wasn't even working. Where's the game? Let's go. Alright, final game coming. Alright, back to the start. Who wants it more? Attack. Bob is they're all desperate to get the queen out. Somehow this weakens the structure of it. When you, this is kind of a Queen's Indian setup, which is fine of course, but some dragon setups are really nice in this variation. I mean in this game, because the king is surprisingly safe, and critically you, when you have this pawn chain, you get a safe square on h4 for the knight. Wow, queen out. Going for sheeples again. Knight d11, knight takes k4. Wow. Wait, bishop takes h3? I think bishop takes h3 here. just go back. Yeah. Now you didn't get much. You really have to push the pawn now. Like, if you don't, there's a mate coming. So can you move the king over? Take knight, queen a7. Wait. This is weird. Yeah. If you take the bishop, then the bishop protects. Ah, right. Now bishop takes d6. That's weird. Bishop takes d6. I like it. Bishop takes d6. Queen takes d6. King takes. Move the king. Time to move the king. Oh no. No. Queen f6, yes. Queen f6. The comeback. Yeah, bishop a9. One, two. So we're going. What a game. So it's now green and blue are up a piece here. If you move the bishop there and discover the attack. Yeah, just go back. You have to move the king out of the center now. Oh no. Ouch. take. Oh, this is ugly. Now this is nice.
No.
Yeah, this is 3-2. Clutch. The comeback, that's really unbelievable. Now you just have to stop the rook from getting active. Like, check. Good move by Khari. That's it. Bring the rook out. Yes, very good. Here we go. Now bishop a6. Very good. Bishop a6. Yeah, what a big comeback. best match so far, I guess. At least the closest one. So this was incredible. Yeah, this one, I mean, D5 is horrendous. Yeah, this was good, very good defense, I think. Yeah, this was the point where what was that? Here? Check. Check. Yeah, that's painful. The mate. Maybe you don't need it. Is this mate? Here, let's say I just take this bishop, knight rook up, then check, check. Okay, you can play this. Now check, take. Check, rook block, take, check. Ah, wasn't mate. Queen I3. Bishop H2. Bishop H2. Knight G2 check. Now if you go to I1, then there's the discover check. So you go here. But then queen takes I2. Bishop H2, queen takes I2 is mate, yeah. So you have to move this bishop or not? Wait, rook up. Yeah. Maybe it's not there. Taking the bishop. And now a bishop move. Then check. Do they run out? Like bishop there. Now red must check blue. Is there a place to hide? I think not. Huh. But you can't move this far because then you get mated. So probably just make a loop. It's close. I think this was the variation that should have been played. I mean, what they did was not horrible. Trading off. Yeah, I think they played really well here. Now this move was probably a big mistake. Like, you can allow this check, but you have to get something going. Maybe bishop I1. Wait. What's that? Here I just take the knight. Wait. Yeah, so what I'm looking at is queen takes b8 check, xclam. Yeah, queen takes g2. Ah, sad. Yes. Bishop takes d6 was very good. Just about. Check. Now check. King over. Queen I. Now you have to block somehow. Wait, let's say you just block it. Maybe I just jump in. Queen I3. take, and then there's no mating. Queen e5. Oh, a call. Hi. So come now. Det här är väl 10 år halv 11 då. Ja, han är... Nej, han är... All right. Yeah. Maybe queen d6 was better. It's not easy. Like, what if you just take here? Now, king g1. Queen of 6. Yeah, it's not the end of the world. I move the rook. Probably should get some light squared influence. Now I block. Doesn't seem like it's mate. Two knights, two rooks. So green and blue are up a piece here, but the blue king is awfully exposed. So I feel like the best thing to do here is to trade off the queens. Like some queen offer and then play bishop h2 check. Because this tandem looks dangerous. But maybe it's an illusion. I'm not sure. We need some nice centralizing move. Maybe this one to cover and the wrong move order. So let's move the rook up. Yeah, and here I would probably consider some bishop move to cover the king more. But I'm not sure we're getting anywhere. Like here. Oh, that's hanging. Probably here, looking for this check. This is complicated. Let's see. Move 11. Yeah, this is not... Alright, so let's just check out the first game. Because that was a really quick one. Let's see. What? Why did he go there? What? This is a horrendous move. This is just mate. I mean, you... Yeah, it's mate. What am I looking at? Check. What the heck? Lol. Yeah, this is over. In this variation, specifically, blue has to play queen d11. Right here. Queen d11, knight i12, and now let's say a random move. Then it's critical that you cover this square. Because now the blue queen can take. The idea is that now, since there's no attack on M6, you kind of survive. Say kind of, but it should work out. Maybe it's the wrong move order. Yeah, let's just make a random move. Bishop out. Now let's say you just grab everything. This looks dangerous, I must say. Maybe this one. Pinning the knight. Let's say I unpin. Or here. What do you do there? Yeah, what do you do there? I guess knight there. But why is this working? Like, okay, let's move the queen. Yeah, maybe. This is so tricky. Because now you're giving the knight, you're hitting the queen. Maybe you can get away with it by pinning. Yeah, and that's why you want this square instead. And I think d11 is a big mistake. Now I don't see what to do. Yeah, because if you grab the rook now, yellow just grabs the pawn and then returns, and red delivers some attack. I mean, red placed bishop g3, and then you just grab the bishop. So this was weird. Wait, what? Ah, so this one, there's a check. That seems to work. So you play there. That does not seem correct to me. Probably this one. The idea is that check and you pick up the queen. It's not working. All right, so check. No. What do you play here? Let's say a random waiting move. So now there's kind of a threat to take and play knight L11. So let's try this one. Yeah, this is probably how you have to play this. So I guess it was okay, but not how you typically want to do it. I'm also curious, what if like knight i3? Yeah, but this is a horrible move. Like, this bishop has a great square. Knight j10 is game over. I mean, you can't even do this. What do you do here? It's just dead. Like, you can't run. If you do this, then I just take. You go here and I open up the queen, and next move I take. Unstoppable mate, I feel. Ah, maybe bishop here. Yeah, but it's still mate. Take. Knight take, bishop take, and that's mate. So I think knight j10 is mate. This is a horrible move. Giving the king an escape square. What the heck? Okay. Yeah, that was weird. Alright, thanks for watching. That's all I've got. So, I feel like game one, Khari and Bab had a mate on the board on move 5, and instead they lost in 10 moves. And then game 2, Clash and Malawi won pretty easily. Game 3, they were also winning, but then made it complicated and lost on time. But I think they were in a bad position. Game 4? Game 4 was... what was game 4? Yeah, game 4. Game 4. Oh, that was the game they lost on time. Ah, yeah, game 3 they were winning and suddenly they hung mate in 1. I mean, there were some practical chances, but game 5 was really the interesting one. I mean, they had mating, Clash had mate there as well. So I feel like it was a close match, chances for both sides, and by far the most evenly matched so far. Yeah, see you for the next one. Thanks for watching.